Do you use Alexa, Echo, or any other Amazon device? Then keep watching because you only have a week to opt out of an experiment that puts your personal privacy and security at risk. So welcome back to this week's video. For those that are like, okay, I got it, Amazon privacy, I've heard enough, you can jump to this point in the video for instructions on how to turn this feature off. If you want the full rundown, keep watching. So on June 8th, Amazon will automatically enroll all devices in Amazon Sidewalk. So what is Amazon Sidewalk? Sidewalk is a communal network where you share a slice of your internet bandwidth with neighbors who don't have connectivity or are out of range. And in return, they help you to their bandwidth when you don't have a connection. It's a you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours kind of setup. And it creates a communal broadband network that any Amazon customer can use. Sounds great, right? Independent privacy researcher Ashkan Sultani explained that with Sidewalk, Amazon is effectively becoming a global ISP with a flick of a switch, all without ever having to lay a single foot of fiber. Unless you opt out of this service, Amazon Sidewalk will use a little bit of your personal wireless bandwidth and data each month. So the monthly data usage is capped at 500 megabytes per month per user. This is the equivalent to streaming about 10 minutes of high definition video like this one. Bandwidth is capped at 80 kilobytes per second, which is about 1/40th of the bandwidth used to stream a video like this. So this campaign makes Amazon's IoT surveillance ecosystem ambitions pretty clear. And given that it is also powered by AI, it needs to be handled with care. So by default, Amazon devices in the US, including Alexa, Echo, Ring, security cameras, outdoor lighting, motion sensors, and tile trackers will automatically enroll in the system. And most people don't take the time to change default settings, so that means millions of users will be enrolled in this program overnight. So what are the risks? Where to begin? Wireless technologies, including Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, have a history of being insecure and subject to things like hacking, eavesdropping, and data breaches. If these industry standard technologies have a poor track record, there's really no reason to believe that Amazon will just have something better that they haven't told us about before. So with Sidewalk, you also won't know who or what is piggybacking off of your network, and you will not know when your devices are connected to someone else's network. This is all by design, according to Amazon, who assures security with three layers of encryption to ensure data is only visible to the intended party, which means it is completely secure until it is not. So the last risk I will cover, and this is certainly not all of them, is that we have never had an IoT network like this before, and therefore haven't done any widespread testing. Amazon no doubt carried out extensive testing in-house, but as a community, we haven't tested it out in our homes, and we don't know what we don't know. So because it's never been done before is not a reason alone to not do something. You know, innovation would never happen otherwise, but not everyone wants to pay to be on Amazon's learning curve, necessarily participate in this social technology experiment. So what are the benefits? Are there any benefits? Should you participate in Amazon Sidewalk? So, maybe. If you have an Amazon device and unreliable connectivity, this may help you get a better ROI on your device investment. If you have consistent problems with setup and troubleshooting, this may also help you with that. And if you use your Tile as a pet tracker and your cat or dog routinely runs out of Wi-Fi range, I guess this would also help. Amazon published a white paper that I will link below, detailing the technical specs and how they plan to protect user privacy and security. I will warn you, the paper is quite comprehensive, and to Amazon's credit, no one has pointed out encryption flaws or loopholes in the noted safeguards. But that doesn't mean that there aren't any risks. So how to opt out? The important part. So Sidewalk is gonna be on by default as a default setting that you have to manually opt out of if you aren't comfortable with the risks. If you don't, it will automatically turn on June 8th. So fortunately, turning Sidewalk off is pretty painless. So first, you're gonna wanna open the Alexa app, open more, and select settings, select account settings, and then select Amazon Sidewalk. And then last, you're just gonna turn Amazon Sidewalk off, and that's it.
you're done.
For some people, such as those with unreliable connectivity, the benefits will outweigh the risks for using this service, but for most people, it just simply isn't worth it. So which camp do you fall into? As always, I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments down below. That is all for this video. I will see you in the next one. Okay, bye.